Hello students, let's read the chapter The Rattrap. This chapter has not only the style but also a typical background of a fairy tale, forests and individuals getting lost. The chapter is both entertaining and philosophical. Through the metaphor of a rat trap, the author highlights of human predicament of temptation. This chapter analyzes the emotional needs of human beings and reinforces the fact that every human being has essential goodness. It only needs to be reawakened. The whole world is a rat trap. The chapter deals with the trap of material benefits that most human beings are prone to fall into. It also dwells on the human tendency to redeem oneself from dishonest ways, focusing on human loneliness and the need to bond with others. It actually brings out our natural tendency to look down upon the have-nots of the society and deprive them of an opportunity to make their lives worth living. The story upholds the idea that the latent spark of human goodness is inherent in each one of us, and the essential goodness of a human being can be awakened through love and understanding. It brings into focus the idea that the world is a rat trap. All the riches, joys, shelter and food, all are lucrative baits to trap mankind. Each one of us can succumb to temptation in our weak moments. The title of the chapter is Rat Trap. Since the peddler's philosophy revolved around rat traps only, it is the most befitting title. The main character is a rat trap seller, and the rat trap is used as a metaphor to highlight the human predicament. The metaphor of the rat trap is reinforced again and again. When the peddler plunders into the forest, he feels like a rat, and the forest acquires the dimensions of a rat trap, set to trap the peddler who succumbed to the temptation of stealing 30 kroners. His greed and guilt keeps on haunting him, and he refuses the invitation of the iron master. But in the end, the peddler redeems himself, breaks through the bars of the rat trap, and distinguishes himself by raising himself to the rank of a captain. So the framework of the entire chapter is that of a rat trap. The central character of the chapter is a peddler who is a homeless wanderer, who has a philosophical bent of mind. Treated rudely, he has become pessimistic and develops a negative bent of mind. When warmth and hospitality is extended to him, he reciprocates ungratefully, but he is conscious of the wrong. He never likes his evil ways, but life had treated him unfairly. The dormant goodness within him needed to be awakened, and this was done by Adla. This world is basically inhabited by lonely souls who need to bond with each other and wish to go up in life like the peddler. The main theme is of baits and temptations that are scattered all over the world in one form or the other. This chapter also revolves around the incident of a vagabond getting trapped due to his greed. On a general level, each one of us can succumb to temptations and get caught. The peddler felt happy to think of others as rats, for they were also cruel to him. Surprisingly, when he knocked at the house of the crofter, he was welcomed by him. Not only this, he was offered porridge, tobacco, and the crofter even played cards with him. He revealed so many things about his life. He showed the money as well. And next day, when the crofter locked the house after bidding goodbye to the peddler, he was greedy, so he smashed the window pane and took away the money which belonged to the crofter. He felt very happy to possess the money with him. And to avoid the main highway for fear of being caught, he decided to go through the forest. He was dead tired and felt depressed that he would die in the forest with those 30 kroners. He sank to the ground in despair. Suddenly he heard the sound of a hammer and realized that there was an iron mill nearby. He summoned all strength and went towards the direction of the sound. He found Ramshu Ironwork, which was a small, and he found that there was a master smith and his helper, and they were busy melting iron and working. A big fire was there and work was in progress. The blacksmith paid no attention to the tramp, as he was used to strangers frequently passing the way. The owner of the iron mill was the ironmaster. He was strict and paid regular visits for inspection. When he saw the tramp sleeping near the furnace, he went near him to have a better look. He could see clearly in the dark forge, and due to the tramp's beard and cap, he mistakes him to be his old acquaintance, Niels Olof. He offered an invitation to the tramp to accept his hospitality and come home with him. The peddler was not pleased to receive the invitation of the ironmaster, for he felt it was too risky. The ironmaster was living with his daughter, and he wanted the tramp to enjoy the Christmas festivities with him. The peddler was surprised to see the ironmaster's daughter at the forge, who had come to invite him. Adela was pretty, modest, and shy, and she had excellent persuasion skills. She introduced herself and repeated the ironmaster's invitation, assuring the peddler any kind of freedom that he wished. She spoke so kindly that the peddler accepted the invitation. She noticed that the peddler was little wary and he had something to hide. Maybe he was a thief or had escaped from jail. The peddler consented to accompany Edla, but inwardly he was cursing himself for stealing the money and putting himself in a risky situation. Ironmaster orders the peddler to be given a bath and new clothes. In broad daylight, the guest appeared very nice and clean, but bore no resemblance to the ironmaster's comrade. He expressed his disgust and shouted at the peddler. The peddler is not intimidated. He blames the ironmaster for forcing him to come here. The ironmaster threatened to call the police and get the peddler arrested. But the peddler turned defiant and told the ironmaster philosophically that even the ironmaster was in the danger of being caught in the rat trap of the world and suffer similarly. The ironmaster was amused to hear this and ordered the peddler to leave. Adela opposed her father and criticized him for being so heartless. She regretted the fact that her father had behaved badly with the peddler, particularly on Christmas Eve. She told her father that she wished the homeless peddler to enjoy at least a day of peace with them, as they had invited him. The peddler enjoyed the Christmas food. He slept peacefully in a bed for the first time. Edla asked him to keep the new suit he was wearing as a Christmas present. He is also extended an invitation to visit them next Christmas as well. The ironmaster and his daughter went for the Christmas service to the church next day. At the church, they got to know that an old crofter had been robbed by a rat trap seller, and the bitter truth dawns on the host. They rushed back and asked the valet about the whereabouts of the peddler. He reported that the peddler had left without taking anything with him, but he had left one packet for Adela. Adela is surprised to see a small rat trap with 30 kroner inside the packet. A letter was found inside the rat trap, which expressed the tramp's deep gratitude for treating him with dignity. He had reciprocated in a captain-like way by returning the money, as Adela had shown great faith in him, and the letter bore the signature of Captain Von Steyl. Students, this is the time to revise the chapter. First short question is, Why is the paddler amused with the idea that the world is a rat trap? Why did the paddler sign himself as Captain Wormstail? And as the long questions you have, compare and contrast the characters of the Iron Master and his daughter. What is the dramatic twist in the story and how does it come about? In this chapter, the paddler is initially a man given to deceit and petty thefts. Driven by hunger, starvation, homelessness, he was a scant respect for anyone. He is not grateful to the crofter for his hospitality and kindness. Even he has no desire to reciprocate to the generosity and the faith reposed in him by the crofter. Contrary to all this, the hospitality and compassion shown by the Iron Master's daughter stirred up the essential goodness of the paddler. She made the Christmas Eve special for him with gifts, a new suit, and even an invitation for the next Christmas Eve. He suddenly decides to reform himself. He leaves a packet for the daughter of the Iron Master. He gifts Adela a small rat trap and even returns the 30 kroner notes which he had stolen from the crofter house. He leaves behind a letter of thanks which is addressed to Adela for being so kind and hospitable. The predicament a man faces is that temptations appear in various forms. Tragically, many times one is not aware of having been trapped, and this goes on deeper and deeper and loses all chances of deliverance. So men must be satisfied with whatever life has to offer.